Good morning. I want to thank you all for being here in the 19th Economic Summit of the Republic of Serbia. Simeon Tomogos, who founded and developed this conference 19 years ago, sent you his warmest regards. Unfortunately, a cold with a high temperature did not allow him to travel and to be present at a conference that he values so much. And rightly so, because during these 19 years that the conference takes place, we have been through important challenges which Serbia faced and developed with strength and self-confidence. Our conference every year addresses all the challenges that the economy and the politics faces and supports all efforts towards strategic reforms, towards economic stability and inclusive growth. This year, the agenda focuses on all these important subjects that I previously mentioned, while at the same time addresses some interesting topics about new realities. The impact that new technologies have on businesses, artificial intelligence, brain drain, is some of the topics that we are going to address these 2 days. And it's going to be addressed by really important experts, both from Serbia as well as international speakers. Of course, the success of this economic summit, which is now on its 19th year, couldn't be possible without our partnerships. We try to be as inclusive as we can, and I would like to take a minute to thank all these important partnerships that we have and value them with this important thank you. So, the Serbian Chamber of Commerce, the Association of Business Women in Serbia, Confindustria Serbia, and the Foreign Investors Council are valuable partners that advise us on content and the issues that need to be addressed. Visa, the last few years, has been a very valuable partner of us, advising us on the new economy and the promotion of the cashless economy and the benefits that this could have. Eurobank, I will say, that is the most valuable partner, supporting us, I think, all the years that we do this conference, and we thank them deeply. Neofyton, Aygo and Canon, Ross, Airport City, Atlantic Group are all sponsoring us and supporting our cause. And the dissemination of the results couldn't be possible without our media partners, Blitz and Tanhug, and also Business Magazine and Econometer, Ekonomski Online, Ekapija and PC Press. The conference and the 19th years owes its success to the prominent speakers that are on this stage every year. We are very deeply honored to welcome Deputy Prime Minister and Minister of Foreign Affairs, Mr. Ivica Dačić, on stage. He is supporting the conference all this year with his presence, with his insights, and please, let's welcome him on stage to open this 19th Economic Conference. Please, Mr. Dačić, let's give him a warm welcome.
Dame i gospodo, vaše ekscelencije, uvaženi gosti, učesnici skupa, dozvolite mi da vam poželim dobrodošlicu i ujedno zahvalim našem domaćinu za dobru organizaciju skupa koji ima za cilj da razmotri aktualne teme od velikog značaja ne samo za Srbiju, već i za ceo region Zapadnog Balkana. Jedino što nisam navikao da Tomokos nije ovde, pošto je on 19 godina već na neki način promoter i glavni organizator ovoga skupa i nadam se da će, da će uskoro ozdraviti. Kao što i sami možete da zaključite na osnovu ove agende, na ovogodišnjem sastanku razmatrat će se brojne teme od značaja za razvoj Srbije i regiona. I kao član Vlade Republike Srbije, kao prvi potpredsednik i ministar spoljnih poslova, želeo bih da istaknem da su ekonomski rast i makroekonomska stabilnost uz puno poštovanje principa održivog razvoja jedan od ključnih, ako ne i najznačajniji, prioritet Vlade Republike Srbije. U tom smislu otvoreni smo za sve oblike saradnje koje bi unapredili ekonomiju Srbije i regiona, istrajavanjem na strukturnim reformama, stabilnoj fiskalnoj politici i promociji investicija. Vlada Srbije nastoji da održi i unapredi kvalitetno i privlačno poslovno okruženje koje će stimulisati, kako inostrane, tako i domaće kompanije da investiraju u projekte u Srbiji. Sve ovo, kao i brojne druge mere Vlade Republike Srbije, vodiće ka jačanju ekonomskih performansi, povećanju izvoza, kao i smanjenju javnog duga zemlje. Paralelno sa tim, značajni napori ulažu se u osavremenjivanje i pojednostavljenje sistema upravljanja na svim nivoima državne uprave, uvođenjem digitalizacije kako bi privredni subjekti što lakše obavljali svoje delatnosti. Kao ministar spoljnih poslova mogu da istaknem da se Srbija i kroz svoj spoljnopolitički nastup kontinuirano dokazuje kao pouzdan partner i faktor mira, stabilnosti i saradnje u regionu, što je, smatram, neizostavan uslov za ekonomski prosperitet bilo koje zemlje ili regiona. U tom kontekstu Srbija u okviru procesa regionalne saradnje i evropskih integracija ostaje dosledna evropskim vrednostima i standardima, kao i unapređenju ekonomske, celokupne saradnje, ne samo ekonomske, naročito u regionu Zapadnog Balkana i Jugoistočne Evrope. Takođe, uključivanjem u projekte od regionalnog i globalnog značaja, poput inicijative Pojas i put, ali i druge forme ekonomske integracije, želi da doprinese još boljem umrežavanju sa partnerima koji dele njene vrednosti i ciljeve. Kroz saradnju kako sa drugim zemljama, tako i sa međunarodnim organizacijama i regionalnim inicijativama, Srbija daje svoj doprinos globalnoj stabilnosti i najznačajnijim globalnim projektima poput Agende održivog razvoja Ujedinjenih nacija do 2030. godine. Aktuelna ekonomska politička situacija u svetu predstavlja značajan izazov za razvoj i stabilnost većine zemalja sveta, pa tako i Srbije, koja ulaže dodatne napore u obezbeđivanju adekvatnog poslovnog okruženja koje bi pružilo osnovu za privredni rast, zapošljavanje i prosperitet. Ekonomske nestabilnosti, vojni sukobi, prirodne nepogode i migrantska kriza su samo neki od faktora koje moramo uzeti u obzir kada razgovaramo o budućim strategijama, koje pored modaliteta za prevazilaženje ovih teškoća treba da sadrže i konkretne ideje za rešavanje ovih pitanja na globalnom i lokalnom nivou. Ova dva dana konferencije biće prilika da nam prominentne ličnosti iz zemlje i inostranstva, javnog i privatnog sektora iznesu svoja viđenja i predloge za unapređenje ekonomije i samim tim kvaliteta života građana Srbije i celog regiona. Ja želim još jednom da ohrabrim sve učesnike da svojom stručnošću i kreativnošću doprinesu ovom cilju. Svim učesnicima bih još jednom i ove godine tradicionalno poželeo dobrodošlicu u Beograd i u Srbiju i želim vam puno uspeha u radu. Hvala vam.
We really thank Mr. Deputy Prime Minister for his opening speech. We value his presence here, especially now that it's a so busy schedule. Without further ado, I would like to call on stage Mrs. Yana Mikhailova, the President of the Board of Directors of the Foreign Investors Council, which is the driving force of the economy. Please.
Dear colleagues, your excellencies, respected members of the government, business community, dear guests of the conference. First of all, I would like to thank the organizers for inviting me to participate in the conference on behalf of Foreign Investors Council. And first, let me give two words who we are. Foreign Investors Council is the independent organization, association, that gathers multinational companies, big investors in the country, who decided to form this council already more than 15 years ago, and who are really, thank you for saying that all these companies are indeed the driving force of Serbian economy. All these companies invested, continue investing in Serbia, and represent various sectors in industries. So throughout these years, foreign investors, members of the Foreign Investors Council invested over 33 billion euros and employ more than 100,000 people. So it's a big organization. And what is our mission? A Foreign Investors Council always advocates for a predictable business environment, play a level field for all investors, not only foreign, but for all investors, and is up of conditions of doing business. And our members participate in the sustainable dialogue with the high-level dialogue with the government, with the experts from the ministers. They have an access, they're heavily engaged in preparing the White Book, which is an annual publication of Foreign Investors Council, where we announce the results of the year and of our work, and where we mark the progress which is happening with the reforms in Serbia for the past year. So now we are in the final stage of preparation of the White Book, which will happen in November. So during this meeting, we plan that we will announce the FIC, we call it index, where we will be able to share the results, what's have been happening in the last year, and which fields of reforms marks the best and the least progress. So this will happen very soon. So, but what we can say today, that we can see that Serbia continues a steady progress in many areas. And first of all, I think the most valuable for whatever investor and for whatever, whoever is participating in the business process in the country, stable macroeconomic environment is of utmost importance. And we can see that quarter after quarter, Serbia demonstrates a healthy growth, and all the numbers are proving that the country is really doing a very good job. And we can see that many parameters are not only growth, but growth of export confirms that Serbia is strengthening the competitiveness in the market, which I think we as a foreign investors value very much, and we contribute to this one. And what is interesting, we can see that Serbia continues to enjoy the good and healthy inflow of the foreign investments. And for sure, this is one of the reasons why it's happening. It's because of stable macroeconomic environment, but not only because of this. I think Serbia has a lot of other good reasons. Together with stable macroeconomic environment, for sure, it's a very solidly developed infrastructure. But I will mention as well the sustainable and very clear policy of Serbian government to communicate that Serbia is an investors-friendly country. I think one of the, this is yet another reason why Serbia succeeded to be recognized by Financial Times as a scorecard, as a or index, as the leading country in a relative term to attract the foreign investors. And I think this is a very big accomplishment. So that's why was one of the subjects and which we discussed during the annual Foreign Investors Council visit to Brussels. We've been in Brussels last week. And during this visit, we've discussed a number of topics. FIC is a recognized partner on this, assisting Serbia on the EU accession path. So we had a number of meetings in different DG, including the one with the, Mrs. Genoveva Ruiz-Calavera, the European Commission's Director for the Western Balkans. So we shared, usually we're coming once a year, and the Foreign Investors Council share their feedback from the from the country, what's going on in the with the business environment, with the reforms, and I think it was a very good meeting. And for sure, we shared our view on the stability and development of the macroeconomic development of the country, and as well, we marked certain things that are needing, that are requiring more attention, and where we expect certain reforms to take place, and this will be the following fields. So we expect that the reforms will be accelerated in tax, labor, trade and inspections, food safety, real estate, and one of the important subjects discussed was the liberalization of Forex. This indeed will be, all these reforms will accelerate the business and their business development in the country, and will positively impact the economic development of the country. And we think that what we can do as foreigners in, foreign investors, our members have significant expertise in regulatory area, good knowledge of Serbian and EU market, and have capacity to provide assistance on the EU path when it is requested. So in conclusion, FIC is really a partner for Serbia for the growth, and what we need for the sustainable development in the country, we need this continuation of fiscal consolidation, which is happening today. We can confirm that I think Serbia is in a good path with all macroeconomic indicators. What we need some reforms, especially in tax area, but what we need, not only reforms of the regulation itself. The most important thing to continue attractive investment is law enforcement. It's implementation of the laws, and it should be even for all kind of the business partners who operating in the country. And the third, what we need more transparency in public consultation before we the laws are changed. I'm sure there are a lot of people who are representing business community who experienced not once what does it mean for the business when the legislation is changing without any announcement, sudden changes are not adding trust to the business. So these three things will for sure be accretive and will be already a good prerequisite for the further development of Serbia, and we as the Foreign Investors Council will continue to contribute as much as we can, welcoming new investors, and I think we are very pleased to see when the new investments are coming to Serbia and joining Foreign Investors Council, and we continue to advocate, as always, as a reliable partner, Serbia on the EU path. Thank you.